Yes, dear children, again one marks question will definitely come from this also, and that is why I am giving you. If you see here, you can see the soil that is existing, and this green color which is being shown, let me use that annotation option of spotlighting. If you see this whole green color, this is the area where you have the mountain soil. So the mountain soil or the forest soil, because mountains are the only place where forests are left, so mountain soil, Nepal not a part of India, that is why they have not shown mountain soil here. Then here Sikkim, they have shown mountain soil. Bhutan again not a part of India. Then Arunachal Pradesh, here again you can see the mountain soil. So mountain soil is existing, or the forest soil is existing in the mountains, one character. Then just at the foothills of the mountain you find the alluvial soil. The alluvial soil, if you see, is present in the whole northern India, say from Pakistan onwards, from Punjab, Haryana, and if you move on to Bangladesh, the whole northern plains is full of the alluvial soil, and all this alluvial soil has been brought by river Ganges, right? So this is a flood plains of river Ganges, a very fertile area, the food bowl of India. And then if I move towards this side, what do you see? You see the area where you have got say the desert soil. So this desert soil is also is mentioned here in the book as arid soil. You can call it arid soil, you can call it desert soil, it is exactly the same. So you can remember it as arid soil, right? Because here the rainfall is very very less. And then come very important area of the black soil. This is the black soil, children. This whole is the black soil. It is black in color. One mark question in the board is definitely going to come from this, okay? And even in the upcoming paper also, one soil type has to come, because the syllabus is very limited, so they cannot undo that. Now red and yellow soil. Now if you see, black soil is black in color, right? And why is it black? Because it is made up of basalt. Basalt is a volcanic origin, and it is one of the most fertile soil. It is also called as a black cotton soil. So these are the characters of this soil. And further, if you look at the red and laterite soil, in this red, the soil is red in color because of oxidation, and soil is yellow in color because of hydration. And what do we see? That the black soil is practically encircled by the red soil. So this is also one thing that you should understand. Red soil is here and in the areas of a lot of rainfall. This area is the area where you have got a lot of rainfall, and here also you can see leaching is there, and here also you can see the red soil existing. So we have done red soil. Black soil is also called as cotton soil, one of the most fertile soil, black cotton soil, and one of the fertile soil is the alluvial soil. So alluvial soil is also very fertile and requires water, which is in plenty in this particular area. And black soil is also very fertile. Both of them are very fertile. This is good for cotton, and say growth of cotton is maximum here. And for sugarcane also, the black soil is good, and even the alluvial plains are good. So once you should see the map, have an idea ki what particular soil will be existing in this particular area. So the major area, if you see what is that particular soil, just remember this whole is laterite, and here it is black, alluvial, desert soil, and arid soil, and then mountain soil. So with this, I can say that you have understood this concept, and I should say thank you.